Hey guys, it's Lily, and I just finished editing the video, and I've noticed that there's a lot of weird noises in the background, like something, like hitting something, like banging, and children screaming, and people talking, and that's because I was filming when my family was home, and they were making lots of noises, even though I told them to be quiet. You know, sometimes it just can't be helped. I tried to cut out as many things as I could. I even, like, refilmed a part because it was just really annoying. And yeah, sorry if it gets really annoying, but I tried my best, and I sadly don't have time to refilm the whole video. Just want to let you guys know that there's gonna be some noises in the background. Just bear with it, and thanks for watching, and yeah, I'm gonna go read this book now for, like, 3 more hours before I go to bed. And yeah, please enjoy the video. I don't know what I'm doing. Bye.
Take it slow, but it's not typical. He already knows that my love is fire. His heart was a stone, but then his hands were on. I turned him to gold and it took him higher. But I'll be a daydream, I'll be your favorite things. We could be beautiful, get drunk on the good life. I'll take you to paradise, say you'll never let me go. Deep in my bones I can feel you, take me back to a time when we knew how to wait. We could waste a night with an old film, smoke a little weed on the couch in the back room, how to wait.
Guys, it's Lily, and today I'm just gonna talk about reading two books at the same time. I feel like this video is too short, so I want to tell a little story. So this is story time plus random talk session video. Let's go. So if you've seen any of my other videos, my old videos, not really old, my previous videos, you'll know that I don't like to read two books at the same time. I don't like to cut off a series and start another one and then go back to the other series, just because I feel like I'm not committed to the book and I don't get the full experience, and I might forget some things in the other series and I might not even restart it again. As you all know, the Fifth Wave movie came out on Friday and today's Tuesday, and I didn't get to watch it. That means that I won't have a review on it because I was in, I think you all know, but I was just reading slump. Then I started this book. I'm only like that much into it. I'm only on the fifth chapter, but I really want to see the movie when it's in theaters. So today I got The Fifth Wave at Barnes & Noble, as you can tell from the little montage thingy that I put together. And I'm thinking about pausing this book, the book that I've been trying to read for 3 months, and start this book. And my friend Christina, she's reading this too. And I thought that if we could finish the book together, then we could go see the movie together, and then maybe I can do a review on it next week. It's gonna be late, but I'm still gonna post it. It's gonna be great. It's gonna be great. So yeah, I think I'm going to read two books at the same time. Well, technically pausing a book, then reading this, and then going back to this. But my only problem is, I don't know if I want to pause this book, read this book, then go back to this book and the series and the Mortal Instruments series, or if I want to pause this book, then read this book, wait for the third book, and go back to the series. I don't know. Life struggles. So I'm gonna talk about the process of getting this book. So I go to Barnes & Noble with my padre because he's nice, and he took me to Barnes & Noble, and I haven't gone there in like a long time. When I first got in, I go to like, there's this one shelf that has like all the, I don't know how to explain it, but it has like all the most recent books that everyone's buying, and I see the hardcover for City of Bones, and I was so tempted to buy it, but I was like, no, I can't, I have to resist. And then I went to look for The Fifth Wave, and at first I saw the soft cover, and I was like, if they don't have the hardcover, this is gonna be the saddest trip to Barnes & Noble. because, I mean, I got the Infinite Sea in a hardcover. I mean, I wanted hardcover too. So when I saw the soft cover and I couldn't find the hardcover, I was really sad. And plus, like, hardcover's better. Comment down below if you like hardcovers or soft covers. Personally, I'm a hardcover kind of girl. I mean, I literally, when I only had like 17 books in my bookshelf, and there were like 7 of them that were soft cover, I mean paperback, not soft cover. I literally rebought all those books in hardcover, except for Shadow Me, because they don't print it in that, like, the eye thingy in hardcover. So yeah, I need to find that and buy it. But right now, it's like the only paperback on my shelf. Does anyone know the difference between softcover and paperback? Because I don't know the difference. So then I finally found a hardcover and I was like, score! But it was the motion picture dust jacket. I mean, technically the book is the same, just changed the dust jacket. But, you know, I kind of want the regular one because I want to match this, and it'd be kind of weird if one was motion picture and one wasn't, and then like the spines wouldn't match, then the third one wouldn't match, and I'm all about matching. So I was sad, but I was like, score, because it's hardcover. And then I kept looking, and I was looking at the paperbacks of the Mortal Instruments, like looking at the, what's it called, the binding, the spine, and like, just because they're supposed to line up to look like the Institute, I think. And I was just looking at the new covers because I've never seen them in person. Sorry for my dog barking. And then I was scanning that whole shelf and I look at the bottom and I see Infinite Sea. And I'm like, cool, they have Infinite Sea in hardcover. And I look next to it and I see the fifth wave, the last one, like this. And next to it was another Infinite Sea, and I was like that. And I was like, oh my god, the last hardcover, regular dust jacket, fifth wave. I need to get this. And I'm not gonna lie, I took like a few seconds to decide whether I wanted this one or the motion picture dust jacket one. But, you know, I got this one. That's pretty much it. And then, oh, also when I was putting back the motion picture one, I found another book. And I don't know if I'm gonna show it to you guys, because I'm gonna be, you know what, I'm gonna show it to you guys. But in my book haul for January, it's gonna be in there. But like, I want to show you guys then, but doing story time, so I'll show you. But this is Soundless by Rochelle Mead, and first attraction, this girl's Asian. I was like, cool, no one like ever writes books about Asian people because like we're so underrated. And then I was like, ooh, pretty detailing around like the cover. And then I was like, oh, Rochelle Mead, I haven't read any of her books yet, but I really want to read Vampire Academy. And I was like, cool, I want to get this book. So yeah, I got it because, for one, because there's an Asian girl, and for two, it's by Rochelle Mead, and I would really like to read one of her works. I mean, I was hoping to start off with Vampire Academy, but this, I don't know if this is a standalone. It doesn't say anything about like a series on it or book one on it. So if it's a standalone, then I can just get a feel for her writing before I read Vampire Academy. And while I was in Barnes & Noble, I was facing the most common book struggle in the whole world. And that's when the books are kind of expensive. This one, this small one, was $19.99. This one was $18.99, even though it's bigger. Okay. And I was like, I really want it. I feel like if I don't get it now, I won't ever get this book again. But I really want this book, but this one, I have to read it. So, you know, this is a necessity, but this is just a kind of a want. So I was like, hey, maybe I'll just like have my dad, and I'd be like, hey dad, I have 2 books. Could you get 2 books for me? I mean, if not, I'll put one back, but like, I really want 2 books. Then when he asked me what the prices were, I was like, $20 and $19. And he was like, what? And I was like, $20 and $19. Plus we get 10% off because we're members. So, you know. And then he was like, could you just get one? And I was like, in my head, I'd choose this one, but I really want this one. And I was like, And then he was like, fine, get two. I was like, booyah. So thank you, Dad, for getting me two books, even though I only really need one.
I think that's all I can talk about for today. Today's just a really random video, but I was really excited that I got the fifth wave, and I'm really excited that I'm reading again because I really like Clockwork Angel, which is why I was like iffy about reading two books at the same time. But I saw on Instagram, Sasha of Bookutopia posted that the movie was really good, so that just makes me want to watch it even more. But obviously, I need to read the book before I watch it, so hopefully I can read this book in a week, and then maybe at the end of the week, I can go watch it with Christina if she's available. Hopefully she is, or if she finishes the book in time, and then I can do a review on it, and that would be awesome. Like, my first movie review, that'd be so fun. That's all I have for you guys today. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up and comment down below anything, like whether you like hardcovers versus paperbacks, books versus ebooks, and video ideas, because those are also great. And subscribe if you haven't already. And yeah, have a great day, afternoon, wherever. Have a great day, afternoon, wherever you are. I know, I forgot night. Have a great day, afternoon, night, wherever you are. And yeah, have a great day, happy night, wherever you are. Bye! This whole, like, blocking it out is the new thing. I like it, so we're gonna stick with it.